Okay, so this introduction to the property management in Malaysia, right? We have content for this lecture, introduction, definition, property management from RSAS guideline, property management in Malaysia, public sector property management activities, properties acquisition, tenancy management, space management, maintenance management, issues and conclusion, right? So we discuss on this particular topic for today, right? The introduction, property assets such as land and building are the key resources for all type of organization, including in public sector. For the last two decades, positive effect of good property management received highly attention as the stock of new building costing billion of ringgit being put into operation. In private sector, the recognition and significant contribution from the property management will drive to the ultimate success of the business, or it will lead to failure of business, right? Property sometimes is very important for the supporting the business needs or the business strategy to make sure organization can make the profit from their property. Okay, for example, public sector. Okay, our university, okay, the ITM Perak, we have property such as our building, our college, our field, okay, and then other facilities such as our lab and everything. So that's property, or that's building can make your ITM operate to has a teaching and learning university. Okay, others, for example, factory, so they need the property to do the business for the production of the goods and the material to ensure that the business can be success. And then we have a property. We must maintain the property, or we manage the property to ensure that property in good condition and support the business needs, right? Thus, the importance of property management should be handled in strategically and effectively manner, right? So that's why we need a good management team to manage our property. Okay, for example, in UiTM Perak, we have BPF, Bahagian Pengurusan Facility, okay, to manage our property. Okay, and then public sector organization property can be considered as having financial contribution and effect upon annual financial statement. And then property resources in the same way as human, financial and information resources contribute to the success of this organization, okay, and need to be effectively and efficiently managed. Right? Our staff and our property also need to manage. Okay, has to be professionally managed to ensure that asset value are maintained. Okay, to memastikan value of the property maintain dan meningkat lah, kan? So kita tahu kalau property we have the value or the price for that property. So sometimes the increment every year or every 2 years, they have increment for the price. Okay, for example, housing, kan? So your house, for example, this year you buy at 500,000, maybe next year 550,000 or 600,000. Okay, so if you not manage your property, maybe the value of the property will decrease. Okay. Add value to organization through effective and creative management. Okay, so that's important of the property management. Okay, we look into the property definition. Okay, collectively refer to block of building, okay, property or several block of building on the same estate for commercial, industrial, residential, car park or public use, incorporating the common area, recreational and leisure facility, landscape garden and building services, installation, and etc. And then property manager shall report to the person or company performing day-to-day overall control and management of a property. Okay, there's a property manager. Okay, for your information, we have the what we call that, the professional property manager registered with BOVIA, okay, Board of Valuer and Property Management Malaysia, okay, ataupun bahasa Melayu dia lembaga penilaian, lembaga LPPH dulu, lama-lama lembaga penilaian hartanah, dan ditambah yang baru sekarang adalah dan pengurusan harta, okay, BOVIA. Okay, kalau you nak boleh tengok dekat apa, you boleh search dekat website, okay, ada dia punya website yang menerangkan tentang BOVIA ni. Okay, dekat UiTM Perak, saya salah seorang bernama ni property manager, okay, ataupun dia panggil bahasa Melayu dia pengurus harta, pengurus harta berdaftar, okay, di bawah BOVIA. Okay. And then property owner is a person who have or a company which own the leasehold interest of a property under a government lease or land grant or individual under assignment execute with a property developer and having the exclusive right of possession and control over the use and occupation of the property. Okay, ini you ada belajar dalam building control, I think, kan? SEM 5, SEM 4 lah, SEM ada belajar kot eh dalam building control. And then the resident or occupier is a person who live in a domestic unit or a person using a visiting a property for business, dwelling, temporary vacation, manufacturing process, leisure or other purposes. Okay, so this meaning of resident and occupier. Property management, administration of residential, commercial, industrial real estate. Okay, property management typically involve the managing of property that is owned by another party or entity. Okay, yang ini maksudnya dia di outsource lah, diberikan kepada orang lain untuk membuat kerja-kerja management. Okay, sometimes ada juga yang dia buat sendiri. Okay, manage their property by itself. Okay, so itu contohnya. Definition lagi on the what do property management entail? Manage property involve establish goals, objective and policy and implementation of strategy to achieve those goal and objective, right? An example, an activity that seeks to control interest in property, taking into consideration the short and long-term objective of property owner and particular purpose for which the property is had. Jadi dia lebih kurang kalau kita nak tengok bahasa mudah dia, yang kecil adalah maintenance lah. Kalau you sebelum ni pernah pergi buat case study, ada pergi jumpa maintenance team, okay, dia orang bagi tahu dari segi apa, macam mana dia orang buat maintenance kepada sesuatu bangunan. Okay, itu bagi skop yang kecil lah, di bawah property management. Okay, sebahagiannya adalah maintenance. Jadi dalam maintenance dia ada objektif, ada goals, ada policies, and then ada maintenance standard. Okay, so that's apa nama panggil dia punya rutin dia lah, okay, ataupun dokumen yang diperlukan dalam maintenance. Dia ada maintenance program, everything lah. Okay, itu untuk maintenance. Lagi the work carried out to manage and maintain the development including its facility at the level that will retain or enhance the value of the development, create a safe, functional and conducive living environment for occupants, keep or restore every facility in efficient working order and in good state of repair and project a good appearance or image for the development. Okay, jadi dia menjaga dia punya apa orang panggil value dari segi pandangan and dari segi penjagaan on the maintenance on the safety, okay, conducive living, and then repair, restore the facility to ensure that facility working or function in accordingly. Okay, this responsibility include all the necessary reporting, accounting, maintenance and decision making to ensure the economic and physical vitality of property assets. Okay, and then we go for the RICS, property management. These are the activity that ensure that land and buildings matter are dealt with so that they operate efficiently and effectively. Okay, now we talk about the efficiently and effectively. Effective and efficient. Okay, we need the strategic or strategy to ensure that property operate efficiently and effectively. Alright, property management by RSAS guideline to ensure, for example, this cost and cost control, space utilization, service level and customer satisfaction, environmental sustainability, risk management, including health and safety, in-house services management practice, outsource supply management. Okay, ini yang dititik beratkan di dalam property measure, performance measure. So apabila kita bagi outsource ataupun we in-house pun sama, we need to ensure that performance of the property in the acceptable level. Okay, acceptable level, because of we need to spend a lot of money for maintaining the property. Okay, okay, in Malaysia, in this view, the author look the three aspect. Okay, ni that ni lah particular author yang menulis berkenaan dengan property management. Okay, the management of the non-physical aspects of building, such as legal and tenants matter. The management of physical aspect of building, such as building maintenance, and the economic management of the operational property assets, such as acquisition, disposal, and development of the property asset. The core of property management may thus involve the management of the physical asset, okay, which include maintenance, organization use management, which include space management or user requirement, financial management, which include property valuation, acquisition, disposal, property investment management and tenancy management. Okay, maksudnya apa yang ada di dalam property tu, okay, perlu di manage dengan betul lah, okay, dan dimasukkan di bawah scope of property management. Jadi kalau you all dah habis belajar nanti, you all nak jadi property manager, okay, boleh. Itu adalah salah satu bidang kita lah, okay. Peluang pekerjaan daripada BS boleh jadi property manager, right? Public sector organization undertake the property valuation, acquisition, disposal, which are normally focused for development of new office. Okay, sometimes ada acquisition ni dia membeli others property. Eh. Okay, contohnya, saya nak bagi contoh yang mudah. Eh. Satu lab, lab testing. Okay, lab testing. Contohnya sirim. Okay. Sekarang ni sirim masih lagi tak ada kepakaran untuk buat testing aero, dia panggil apa, aero engineering, okay, ataupun untuk kapal terbang, pembinaan kapal terbang, okay. Jadi sirim belum ada lagi kepakaran, so dia tengok di paling dekat ada di Singapore, okay, contohnya ada Singapore. Ada lab yang boleh buat testing untuk aero engineering ni ataupun pembinaan kapal terbang, dari segi nak testing dia punya material, nak testing dia punya engine contohnya, kan? Ataupun nak testing dari segi painting works. So sirim cuba untuk membeli that that company, that lab, laboratory tadi tu, lab untuk buat expansion of their business. Jadi bila dia beli that lab dengan company dia sekali, so dia akan dapat operate dia punya dia punya testing untuk aero engineering contohnya lah. Lagi satu yang terbaru baru ni, kalau you all ingat Proton kan, okay, Proton nak expand dia punya dia punya teknologi di dalam pembuatan kereta. So dia kerjasama dengan company daripada China, kan. So company China beli dia punya share sikit, okay, Proton sikit untuk bekerjasama, okay. Ataupun dulu Proton pernah membeli Lotus, kan. Dia pernah beli Lotus untuk expand dia punya automobile teknologi, okay. Itu dari segi property lah, kan, termasuklah kilang ke ataupun orang yang ada dalam Lotus sebahagiannya dibawa masuk ke dalam inilah team Proton. Jadi Proton yang punya lah, right? Tu Satria Neo Lotus, okay, betul lah. Dia mengeluarkan beberapa model, right? Jadi itulah cara-cara company yang besar-besar dia akan buat cara acquisition lah. Itu dia panggil acquisition. Okay. Tenancy management concern to the involvement of public sector organization is limited to the occupation of office space in private building. Okay. Sometimes dia menggunakan bangunan lain dan dia sewa lah. Okay. Ada sebagainya macam tu lah. Property investment management aspect, the central government organization are not involved directly, but rather the quasi-government organization. Okay, and then should be noted that Malaysian public sector is defined as the central government. Okay, state government, local government, statutory bodies, and the non-financial public enterprise. Alright, however, okay, ini tak ada apa lah. Okay, public sector property management activity, okay, no single best model that could suggest the type of property management activities can be organized and related to others management functions within large organization, particularly in public sector. Okay, maksudnya dia kata tak ada yang best yang boleh propose lah. Ini isu lah kan, kita tengok sebagai isu. Okay, the choice of what activities constitute property management depend mainly on the objective property management itself, the choice of channel and the mandate of property function. Others, dia kata apa? May also affect the choice of property management activity. Jadi, property management dia bergantung kepada type of property, normal apa punya, normal activity ataupun main activity on the in the property. Contohnya UiTM for teaching and learning. Okay, for office building, the different dia punya needs of the property ataupun business. Expanding function of an organization may require acquisition development. So, ini bukan sama. Property management division normally manage common central government office. Secondly, an occupier agency manage office buildings that the agency solely occupy. Okay, and then finally, outsourcing of property management function will be outsourced. Company handle all the routine property level management activity. Okay, kebanyakan kita outsource lah. You tengok hospital pun sama kan, dia outsource kepada dulu, apa nama dia, dulu Fiber. Sekarang dia jadi UEM Agenta. Dia outsource kepada luar. Okay, type of management, property management division, PMD, ataupun occupier agency ataupun outsourcing property management function. Okay, ini adalah management organisation in public sector, property management. So ada tiga cara, tiga jenis three type of management organisation. Okay, public sector property management activity in the case of common central government office building, all the overall responsibilities on the property management aspect, while the others agency act on advisory capacity. Okay, this table, Ministry of Work, common central government public office managed by PMD of Prime Minister Department. Okay, the numbers of complex and numbers of building. Okay, Kuala Lumpur and Selangor 3, numbers of building 7. Okay, this updated from to that dimension. Tahu bila? Okay. Public sector property management activities. In the case where our occupier agency manage the office building, that management of such building is subjected to the guideline and rule imposed by PMD. Okay. Okay, yang lain-lain you all boleh baca. The responsibility for property management are distributed among the numbers government department such as JKR, PWD, Public Work Department. Okay, public sector property activities, physical building management, financial property management and organization use management. Okay, include the space management, cost containment, responding to chance. Okay, and then okay, kita tengok on the property acquisition, is the financial aspect of property management. In practice, involve direct property purchase, building construction and compulsory acquisition of purchase of land or land alienation from state authority. Okay, the overall responsibility lay with the PMD and FCLN, while the under government agency act advisory capacity. Okay, government property coordinator committee under the secretary of PMD oversees the whole function of property acquisition. Okay, direct property purchase any government agency can make direct property purchase either for development building or an ongoing project or development or completed project. Okay. And then building construction, the PWD oversees all planning and construction of central government project. Eh? PWD, Public Work Department or JKR in Malay. Jabatan Kerja Raya. Okay. Compulsory land acquisition or purchase. That's what acquired vacant land through compulsory land acquisition, purchase and land alienation from state authority for development of office building. Okay. Yang ini acquisition, sebab apa ada acquisition di antara government? Because of the land belong to state government, not belong to the central government. Okay. Apa nama ni? Kerajaan Persekutuan kena beli ataupun kena membayar sesuatu satu amount kepada apa kerajaan negeri jika ingin membuat pengambilan tanah. Okay. Ataupun untuk membeli apa nama ni, membina sesuatu property ya, central ataupun federal government eh, nak buat sesuatu property di atas tanah kerajaan negeri. Okay. Rental of office space in private property, the committee on office space under PMD deal with request for rental space by various government agency. Okay, banyak juga government yang menyewa office daripada private. Okay. And then space management. Space is the organizational use aspect in property management. The primary aim in space management is to make the most efficient and effective use of space, equipment and furniture during the present time as well as in the future, and to provide an environment which enable the large cost and most important asset of the organization, its people, to operate. Okay, according to Abdul Rahman 1999. Okay. Effective space management can be discussed from two broad areas, namely cost containment, responding to Chan. Okay. Cost containment required the understanding of quality. Its objective is to provide the best possible support for the full range of activities critical to organizational survival at lower possible cost over expected of use. Okay. Apa-apa pun kita bercerita tentang kos, kita nak dapat kos yang rendah dan dapat servis yang bagus. Nah, itu biasalah kan. In government building pun sama, dia memikirkan tujuan yang samalah. Chan is the direct result of organizational chain and office chan in the relocation of an individual or group of individuals, resulting in a change to the office environment. Okay, in this context, the main purpose of space management is to reduce the amount of space needed to carry out a certain function while at the same time improving the quality of facility. Right, space management ni kalau contoh dekat UiTM, apabila kita masukkan ramai pelajar. Okay, contoh sekarang di UiTM Perak, Kampus Sri Iskandar, kita ada lebih kurang 10,000 pelajar. Okay, jadi untuk menambahkan lagi pelajar menjadi 12,000, kita kena buat pengiraan dari segi space audit. Pengiraan sama ada space UiTM Perak cawangan Kampus Sri Iskandar ni cukup tak untuk cater student seramai 12,000 orang. Okay, kalau tak cukup, kita, laporan yang diberikan adalah tidak cukup, tidak boleh memuatkan 12,000, hanya boleh muat maksimum contohnya 11,000 saja. So, pengambilan pelajar dikawal lah untuk melihat dari segi ruang yang ada di UiTM di Kampus Sri Iskandar ni. Okay, itu contoh dia lah. Okay, maintenance management. physical aspect of property management, maintenance management is a management system or procedure designed to allow building owner or manager to look after their building in an efficient, well-organized and cost-effective manner. Okay. In other words, the maintenance manager combats the effect of physical deterioration in an attempt to maintain the premise at the level comparable to its initial condition. Okay. Therefore, maintenance management covered most of the building operations and maintenance function. Okay. Jadi, dah akan tengok on the physical asset. Okay. The issue of public sector property management and comment management process, as I mentioned in the foregoing, the responsibility for property management are distributed among a numbers of government department. Okay, dia akan gantung pada masing-masing lah. Okay, kalau government building. And then, property information management, three aspects of the management: physical, financial, and organizational use. Okay. Maintenance management, corrective and preventive maintenance of maintenance management in public sector are well focused within the supervision of PWD. Okay, so means JKR yang mengeluarkan guideline, mengeluarkan standard untuk diikuti oleh others government department. Okay. Space management, more than evaluation of space need. Okay, yang saya sudah beritahu tadi. In related to space planning, management process and space utilization to determining exactly how many people with the facilities adequate support. Okay. Yang saya cerita tadi, macam mana nak kita masukkan student, cukup ke tak space yang kita ada. Okay. Okay, property is an important resources and public sector organization have started to take step to improve their management practice. The approach adopted has verified and the challenge will be for the authorities to consider their priorities in relation to their own organizational and service objective and their own properties. In accordance to the this public sector should adopt property portfolio management, which is a more holistic view of property management. And then property portfolio management is an ongoing process with continual monitoring and review to ensure that the objectives are being achieved. Right? So, any question?